Hi everyone, I'm Shyam. In this video, I'm going to discuss the recent notification that is IBPS clerk. IBPS clerk notification has already been out. Most of you must be knowing it. And if some of you do not know that, please check the internet and find out the details from the notification. IBPS clerk notification has come. The exam is in the month of December. And you can apply for the clerk exam. The last date is in the September month, and this video I'll try to share with you how to prepare English for IBPS clerk. I think you must be knowing the basic pattern of the examination. You have the prelims, and then if you're qualified, then you have the mains, correct? And in the prelims exam, English is for 30 marks. There are 30 questions and 30 marks, and the time given for the English section is 20 minutes. I think you must be knowing it. So there are 30 questions to be answered in the English section, and the time given is just 20 minutes. So you know the total exam, the total prelims exam is you have hardly 1 hour, and English has 20 minutes. Now please understand very carefully, listen very patiently. There are 30 questions to be solved in 20 minutes, which means every question has not even 1 minute. So some questions need to be answered in less than a minute, correct? There are 30 questions and 20 minutes. If you understand this point and take this point seriously, your approach will definitely change. Because once you understand the challenges involved in the work that we do, we will be more focused, correct? In the IBPS clerk exam that you're going to write in the month of December, I'm talking about English. There are 30 questions to be answered in 20 minutes. Now that I have told you this clearly, we have to discuss what are the sections in the English paper, and every section what is the time that we can hardly spend, and what are the topics we have to study. So we will discuss all those details in this video. So in this short period of time, I'll go very precisely by discussing the sections first. I have already told you there are 30 questions to be answered in 20 minutes. So if you know the sections properly, we have the responsibility to do the analysis. Every section, how much time should I spend? Correct? Right. So very commonly we know in any bank exam, whether it is SBI or IBPS or any bank exam, there is a compulsory section called passage. That is called reading comprehension. Then there is a section called close test. We have fillers. Fillers are a kind of filling the blanks. I'll talk about it. Then we have sentence completion or sentence improvement. And then definitely we have a common section called error analysis or error detection. You can also call it spot the error. So generally there are 5 sections. No doubt these 5 sections will definitely come in the IBPS clerk. And let me now tell you a very simple point. 30 questions and 20 minutes, correct? So, and I have told you the sections. Passage you have, close test, fillers, spotting the errors, and then sentence completion or improvement. I'll ask you a very simple question. Listen carefully. I'll ask you a simple question. Out of these sections that I have told you now, tell me which sections can be answered very quickly. Means which sections don't really consume our time much. Do you think you can do a passage in less than 1 minute? No, not at all. Do you think you can do the close test in less than a minute? Yes, some can, but some can't. But what about the fillers? What is a filler? You will have a sentence where there are blanks. If there is one blank, filling the blank. If there are two blanks, you can call it double filler. So you're reading a sentence and finding the options, finding the right answer from the option. So I want to tell you clearly, differentiate the sections clearly into two types. Number one, paragraph and close test keep in one category, because they take time. How much fast you read, definitely you need to spend more than a minute to read the paragraph and get the answers, correct? So paragraph and close test you keep in one category, and the remaining sections you keep in another category. When I say remaining sections, fillers, sentence completion, spotting the error in one category. Now in one category you have passage and close test. Never start an exam with these sections because they take a lot of time. I have seen some people who are good at English, they start with the closest because they can really do it actually. But sometimes what happens is, by the time you finish the closest, time is gone. And even in the closest, there is no 100% possibility that your answers are right. Because in close test, a passage is given where some blanks are there to find the right option. And sometimes you will find the options extremely close to one another. You will find the options like synonyms. All the options carry the similar meaning and you are now confused which word is suitable there. Because vocabulary is a challenge where you should know the meaning of the word and also find out whether it is suitable in the exact sentence. Apt vocabulary has to be chosen there, correct? So never start the exam with passage or closest. It is always the right thing to start the exam with grammar part. That is the other category. In the other category, what are the sections that you have? You have something called fillers. What is filler? A sentence where there is a blank or two blanks or three blanks, you find the right word. And usually fillers are based on vocabulary. Fillers are truly based on vocabulary. Very hardly, if you are lucky enough, you will get fillers where the question is based on prepositions or articles or conjunctions and easy to answer. But 99% fillers come to test your vocabulary knowledge. At least from today, you have the exam in the month of December. You have not less than 60 days from today, correct? And in the 60 days, every day you read 20 words. Definitely 1000 words are going to help you in the close day, in the fillers. So there is no shortcut to the fillers, students, I am telling you. How to get a good score in the fillers? There is no shortcut. There is no secret. The only solution is study the vocabulary. So fillers is a section going to test your vocabulary knowledge. And if you know this, then why do you neglect studying the vocabulary? Start from today. So I'm talking about fillers purely based on vocabulary. Now what is the other section? Spotting the error. Many students have a common question. They keep asking me the question. Shyam sir, how to study spotting the error? See, please understand. Spotting the error is not a topic. Spotting the error is not like tenses to teach. Sometimes people ask me, Shyam sir, please teach me spotting the error. And I'll tell them, I cannot teach you spotting the error because it is not a topic. There are some topics like tenses, prepositions, articles, conjunctions and so on. Conquered, you know, so on. Noun, adjective, verb and so on. Spotting the error is not a topic. Spotting the error is the application of those topics. So if you really want a good score in spotting the error, what you should do? Don't buy a book on spotting the errors and do that. No use. If you really want a good score in spotting the error, learn the topics of grammar. Because most of the times, spotting the errors are based on grammar. You can have a small error based on tenses. In the place of has been, he will use have been, which is a part of tenses or helping verbs. Or sometimes spotting the error is based on prepositions. In the place of of, he will give you at. In the place of by, he'll give you since. Sometimes spotting the error can come, you know, to test your knowledge on conjunctions. In the place of in spite, he will give you despite. In the place of lest, he will give you even though. So if you really want a good score in spotting the error, learn the grammar topics. Find the right coach and learn the topics in the grammar perfectly. Don't compromise. Don't think that's okay, I will not learn grammar but I want a good score. No, it's like basic foundation. In mathematics, you will learn the numbers, right? You will learn the squares and square roots, cubes and cube root, right? Similarly, in the English, if you don't learn the grammar topics, this is the application part. Nobody can help you. So, spotting the error, the only solution is learn the topics of the grammar perfectly with lot of patience. That is about spotting the error. And sentence completion, sentence improvement, again based on grammar part. So, if you learn the vocabulary, fillers, you can get 100 out of 100, 100%. If you learn the grammar part perfectly, sentence completion is, yes, you can gain the good score there and even the error detection is yours. That is how the grammar part, the second category sections, run fast to gain the score. In the 20 minutes of time, make sure in maximum 7 or 8 minutes, finish all the three sections. Spotting the error, fillers, sentence completion. And fix a time, maximum 7 minutes. in the remaining 13 minutes, go for the second category. That is the other category, that is passage and close test. And many people have a common question they have been asking me for a long time. How to gain a good score in passage? Please understand, I'll tell you very simply, very openly, very honestly. Paragraph, nobody can teach you. If you really want a good score in paragraph, it's completely in your hands. The diamond is in your hands. The weapon is in your hands. Others can't do anything in paragraph. Openly, I'm telling you. If you really want a good score in paragraph, the solution is only one. Simple solution. Read newspaper every day. But when you read newspaper, try to read it fast. See, casually for the current affairs, read the paper slowly. That's a different case. But if you want a good score in paragraph, what is important there? Reading ability and speed. Correct? Reading ability and also reading very fast, simultaneously understanding the meaning. Only then you can answer the questions. Correct? So paragraph, nobody can help you, my dear students. Paragraph is entirely in your hands. Start from today, go to the market, buy the Hindu newspaper, read some articles. Don't read the complete paper, not required. Read two or three articles, especially in the editorial column. And then you will see a miracle happening in the case of paragraph. And the last category is close test. Close test is a paragraph where some blanks are given to choose the right option. It is again a mixture of reading speed and also testing your vocabulary knowledge. If you are looking for a good score in close test, Hindu newspaper is going to do the required magic. No English teacher can help you get a good score in close test or paragraph. Grammar part, leave it to the English teachers. They will help you in the best possible way. Spotting the errors, teachers can guide you. But paragraph and close test, teachers can't do much about it. Logically, it is in your hands. But please manage the time. When you go to the exam, when you start taking the test, take the test, right? The first priority should be for the grammar sections. And the second priority should be the close test and paragraph. In the grammar section, maximum don't cross 6 or 7 minutes. Out of the 20 minutes, 6-7 minutes, finish the grammar part. Rest of the time, go to the paragraph. But practice quickly. Do the things very fast. And finally, I would like to end the video by telling you some important books. Because many people ask this question, Shyam sir, what books should I study for English? What books should I study for English for competitive exams? I don't want to suggest you one common book because we all have our own different opinions, but any book of Arihant publications is going to help you very much. You can buy any English book of Arihant for competitive exams. And I used to practice a lot in my earlier days, a book called S. Chand. Even today you can buy the book in the market, S. Chand, 10,000 Objective Questions. There are 10,000 questions. You have 1,000 spotting the errors. You have 1,000 what we call close tests. You have 500 jumble sentences. You have, 500 fillers. All the sections you have together 10,000 questions. Imagine. And also the solution, key and the solution. So if you practice the grammar perfectly every day, study the vocabulary every day, now you have the content available in your hands. Theory is ready. Now practicals. Buy the S. Chand book. Test your knowledge. Practice, 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 practice. Regular practice is required. And please understand, English is a scoring section in your entire IBPS clerk exam. Please don't have anglophobia. Some people have anglophobia. What does that mean? Fear of English. Not at all. Take it easy. And this is something about how to study English for IBPS clerk exam. Any query that you have, you're welcome to send me the message. You're welcome to comment. I'll try to answer your queries. I wish you a very good luck for IBPS clerk exam. All the best.